Hello everyone, I'm Aakansha. I'm an independent full-time open source maintainer and I'm really excited to speak at ViteConf 2024. I'm one of the core maintainers of Excalidraw and last year we migrated from Create React App to Vite, which was not just a regular migration but a huge collaborative effort between the Vite and Excalidraw communities. And today in my talk, I'll be diving into this amazing collaborative journey and share the experience. So let's get started. Let's go a little back when Vite was at a very, very early stage. So on March 19, 2021, Partak posted this on Twitter or X. He basically tried out integrating Vite into Excalidraw's dev environment, and he shared that the developer environment time, the HMR time, reduced to half by 50%, which was really amazing to see. And this caught our attention and we were really excited to see that, okay, there is some interesting fast build tool coming up and we should be keeping an eye to it. So that's how we got to know about Vite. And 2 years later, Wes Braga, in one of his live workshops, chose Excalidraw to showcase migration from CRA to Vite and what are the steps needed to do it. And he also opened a pull request on the Excalidraw repository as well for the same. And this also gave us an idea on what amount of effort we needed if we want to migrate to Vite at some point of time. Few months later, we started considering this as a priority that, okay, we should migrate to some better built tool to improve the developer environment and the overall maintenance of the project. And we chose Vite to do so. Let's look at the reasons why did we go ahead with Vite. So the build time of Vite is definitely significantly faster than CRA, Create React App. And even the hot module replacement HMR is faster in Vite as compared to CRA. There were a lot of case studies available on the web to understand the time difference and how Vite is better. And a lot of articles as well. So yes, we were definitely excited to try out Vite for these reasons as well. And CRA, if you have used, it has this strict rule that you cannot really import anything outside the source folder. So all your code stays inside the source folder. And this was at times a hindrance for us because being a monorepo, we wanted to decouple the source code and move files outside the source folder as well. But this was not possible due to this limitation, and since we didn't have this any such strict rule, that was really good news for us. And CRA was no longer maintained and not recommended by the official React docs as well, so we wanted to move away from CRA at some point. And the most important point, Vite is growing and has an amazing community. The amount of community has been insanely high, so that was a really great news for us, and we really wanted to try out Vite. So the next step was to come up with the to-do list of how we can go ahead with the migration, what are the tasks needed for us to migrate the entire project to Vite. So this was the entire list of the to-dos. As you can see, migrating to Vite variables, the dev build, the production build, the NPM package which we have, the service workers, the PWA, the tests, everything we wanted to migrate to Vite. We didn't want to take it as small steps and then leave something for later. So we wanted to take some time and migrate the entire project to Vite. And it started very smoothly. The documentation has been great in Vite as well as Vite test, all the other plugins as well. But still, there were certain tasks which where we needed some support and help from the community as well to help us resolve it. And those were migrating the test to Vite test, service worker, and PWA. So all these plugins, all the Vite related plugins were at a very early stage. All the plugins were at 0.x version. Even the Vite test was, I think, at 0.3.x version. And service workers at PW, everything. So now we started migrating the test to Vite test and it was running smoothly. But there are a couple of issues we faced when migrating the test. And I'll be diving into all these three tasks and how we were able to resolve it with the help of support from the community. So let's first understand migrating the test to Vite, what were the issues we faced. So since Excalidraw is a canvas-based editor, we often have to mock the canvas to write the test. And for this, we use this library, Jest Canvas Mock. This basically helps you to mock the canvas. And since we were migrating to Vitest, we came across this library, Vitest Canvas Mock, which is basically a wrapper over the Jest Canvas Mock, and it is compatible with Vite. So we migrated to this library, there were some errors which were throwing up when we tried to use this library. And one of the issues was this error which was being thrown, basically prototype of undefined. This was some unhandled error rejection. And I opened an issue in the Vitest Canvas Mock repo to understand and discuss how we can actually resolve this to unblock the migration. And on further debugging, I realized that, okay, this error is not really coming from the Vitest Canvas Mock repo library, but from the Jest Canvas Mock. And since Vitest Canvas Mock is a wrapper over Jest Canvas Mock, the error is being thrown from Vitest Canvas Mock as well. There was an issue created in Jest Canvas Mock as well for the same. And it was being thrown from 2.5.x. And sooner, in few days, Robert Soriano, creator of Vitest Canvas Mock, released a patch version with downgrading the Jest Canvas Mock to 2.4.0 so that we are not blocked on this. And sooner, even the Jest Canvas Mock released a patch version 2.5.2, fixing the issue. And a few days later, Vitest Canvas Mock also released a patch version 0.3.3. So everything was in place. Everything was working well, and this issue was resolved in a very smooth manner. And a lot of people were involved, if you see. So yeah, ultimately, this issue was resolved. Now, there was another issue which we were facing when migrating the test. The best thing was that the Jest API and the Vitest API was very similar, was kept very similar, so that the migration is very smooth. So there is this API called require actual. Basically, when you want to mock some utilities or some functions of a file, or basically a file partly, not entirely, you basically require the actual file and then basically mock that a particular utility or mock that particular function. So in this case, I am trying to import the scene slash export file and mocking the export to SVG. Now, similar to require actual, there was this import actual in Vitest, and the syntax is very similar as well. So I tried to migrate the syntax, and unfortunately, this ran into some infinite loop and the test started hanging. So I went ahead and opened the issue in the Vitest repo regarding this. This took some time to resolve. But in the meanwhile, we were able to fix this with a combination of spying and mocking. So instead of using the Vitest mock API, what we did is import the entire file and then create a spy on that particular utility and then just mock implement. Use the mock implementation API to update the implementation as per your needs. And this helped us as well. And later, in a few months, this issue was resolved as well. So this particular mock and spy thing was not needed. So yeah, and with this, all the issues related to tests were resolved and all the test cases passed, everything was great. So yes, we were able to successfully migrate to Vitest. All the tests were migrated to Vitest. Awesome. So now I would like to share the next task, which was service workers and PWA, progressive web app. This is essential part when it comes to Excalidraw because we offer offline support and progressive web app as well. So now, again, this was very smooth with the help of Vite plugin PWA, which was again at a very early stage as well. In CRA, if you have used, you basically have a lot of, you might have to write some custom code. You have this workbox dependencies as well. But in Vite plugin PWA, it was all, concised to just a small config. You basically give the config and it will take care of it automatically. You don't have to write any extra code. So we were able to migrate it, but there were certain issues which we were facing. And there were two issues which we were facing, to be precise. Now, number one is we create this runtime cache for locales. So Excalidraw supports internationalization. And for that, we create a runtime cache for locales so that we don't want to pre-cache it in the service worker because all the locales will be pre-cached at once. Instead, as the user switches the language, as the requests are fetched from the network, we want to create a runtime cache. So only those languages will be cached which are being used. And similar for fonts and font.css. So we wanted to basically create a runtime cache for locales, fonts, and the fonts.css file. So we the way you do it is you basically, with the help of, since it's all config, so basically create a config for runtime caching. You tell the URL pattern. In this case, I'm basically creating a runtime cache for fonts. So it's TTF and ODF and WFF2. You specify the type of handler, the caching strategy. Cache first is basically it checks first in cache and then it fetch, if it's not present, it fetches from the network. You name it the cache. In this case, it's fonts. Give it the expiration strategy, max entries, and what is the maximum time you want to keep it. So it's 90 days in this case. So this works fine. But for some reason, it was not working for locales specifically. So I went ahead and created an issue in the Vite plugin PWA repository explaining the issue. As you can see, all the locales are being pre-cached in the service worker pre-cache. And there was this, in the documentation, I came across this navigate fallback denialist attribute with the help of which we can actually avoid pre-caching certain files or folders. But it didn't work out. So I created this issue so that we can discuss and, you know, understand how we can, you know, take it further and get unblock on this so that we can migrate to PWA with the help of Vite plugin PWA. Now, the interesting part here is this was not a straightforward resolution. It didn't have a straightforward resolution. We've had a lot of back and forth conversations. If you notice, it has 59 comments in this issue. So there were these many conversations. And after a lot of back and forth conversations, we were finally able to resolve it with the help of custom rollup config. So what we basically do is we have this manual chunks. We go through all the chunks and basically check the path if it is package Excalidraw locales, which is basically the locales path. And if it doesn't have these two particular files, which is en.json and percentages.json, because en.json is basically the English file, we want to load it always by default. So we don't need to keep it in the runtime precache. And same for percentages, that is not needed at all. So if it is in package Excalidraw locales folder, excluding the en.json and percentages.json file, then let's just push it to the locales chunk. That's it. And this actually helped us to create the runtime cache and successfully have those chunks as we wanted. And yes, after this, all the PWA queries were successfully resolved and PWA was possible just with the help of config. No custom code was needed. No workbox dependencies were needed. And the interesting part is debugging was much more easier. So in CRA, the debugging was not that smooth. Whenever there was something we wanted to debug in local, making the service worker run in local was a little bit difficult. But in this case, the service worker, the PWA was very much easy to, you know, debug stuff in the local. And that was really great. And huge thanks to Joaquin Sanchi for this, for helping us throughout all and supporting us throughout for resolving all the PWA queries related to Vite plugin PWA, because it wouldn't have been possible without the support from Joaquin Sanchi. So yeah, and yes, we deployed to production on July 26, 2023 and everything went as we decided, but not really. We had to revert the migration within few minutes because we came across some issue which was a big hindrance for us, which was a big blocker for us. And that is the developer experience got impacted to a great extent. So what happened is in a dev environment, when you are basically editing some huge file, which has like thousands of lines of code, and we have a couple of these files in Excalidraw. And when you edit these files, the HMR gets very slow. Basically, it takes around 8 to 10 seconds in Mac and around 15 seconds in Windows to load. And even shows blank and started showing blank screen. So this was a very big impact on the developer experience. So we had to immediately revert the PR. And then we started debugging the issue. And Joaquin again started looking into profiling, that how can Vite profiling can help us to understand where is the time getting consumed. And then we had been having internal discussions as well. And then finally, we were able to resolve it. We removed the Vite plugin ASLint, and we were able to reduce the time from 8 to 10 seconds in Mac and 14 seconds in Windows to just 3 to 4 seconds. And we also integrated Vite plugin checker. This was really pretty, really fast, and it as it runs behind a worker thread. So it was really fast, and it also shows these errors in browser, which is great. So you just had to, don't have to just look at the terminal. You just look at the browser. And yes, and then next day, 27 July 2023, we were able to deploy to production. And since then, it has been working awesome. So a huge, huge shout out to the whole Vite community, without whom this wouldn't have been possible. And also congratulations to the Vite community on crossing the 1000K Cadaveris milestone. That's a really a big, big achievement. And yeah, kudos to the whole Vite community. And thank you so much. Thank you so much, Partak, for inviting me. And I had a great, great time preparing the talk and sharing this experience as well. And thank you to the audience for listening to my talk. If you have any feedback, any questions, please reach out to me. You can scan this QR code and we can connect on socials. I would love to connect with each and every one of you. Thank you so much. I'm really looking forward to the rest of the amazing talks which you have in this conference. So yeah, goodbye. Thank you so much.